we did a bunch of stuff go down in this episode, so we are just gonna power through this.
Don't try to stop us. We're taking back what's ours.
Stop you? I'm gonna join you. I know where the good stuff is.
I apologize. I was completely out of line. This is a fun looting and rioting. Oh, gee, well, that shut me up. Seriously, these moments were really funny, but it is a young demographic show, so it kind of has to be.
We have to deliver Zaheer's message to Korra immediately.
So Zaheer sent Mako and Bolin to go find Korra when they had no idea where she was. Time is obviously not of the essence for him. Well, I guess in times of chaos, there really is no such thing as a time clock. Plus, having to go from Misty Palms and then to Zhao Fu, yep, that's a healthy chunk of time that'll make sure that you get all the way to the Air Temple first. Wait, never mind, that was actually a good plan.
I can't abandon the place where I raised my family.
She won't leave when none of her other family will leave without her and the building is burning down. Yeah, your family dedication sure is confusing. You know, there really isn't anything more irritating than watching somebody look for someone whom you already know where they are. Well, at least that didn't last very long. Makes you wonder why we even had to watch it at all. Aw, spirits are rebuilding the ice geyser! Hey, this is the first legit sign that combining both worlds was actually a good idea! Oh, how this should end! Spirits should team up with the Avatar to take out the Red Lotus! It'll make the ending of Season 2 have a point! Plus, it'll be like the world telling Zaheer how it wants to be balanced. Yay, we got to see Iroh again! And try to tell me that Korra talking to Zuko wasn't, like, the best moment in this episode. Avatar callbacks, original Avatar character, and we almost literally see a glimpse of the old Zuko when he hears about his uncle. There needs to be a shot with the two of them together at the end of the season. There just needs to be.
You knew Aang better than anyone.
Yeah, Katara really appreciated that, Korra. She was only his wife.
He's headed to the Northern Air Temple as we speak. He said he's gonna wipe out the new Air Nation and everyone in it, unless you turn yourself over to him.
Ultimatums and hostages are always tough choices, but often cheapened in fiction because consistently the only effective action has been to decline and find a way around it. Because if you give in, the bad guy is only gonna double cross you, so it's basically useless. Cue a bunch of commenters pointing out examples where that actually worked. I'm sure there's some.
No!
Anyone else thinking of Elfin Lied? And man, this is another amazing action set piece that, while showing the Red Lotus ultimately victorious, still shows they're not all powerful and for a moment might have actually been given a run for their money. I mean, Tenzin totally could have taken Zaheer if the others didn't come in and gang up on him. And he still held his ground decently for a while. I love kick-ass Tenzin.
Give up. It's over.
As long as I'm breathing, it's not over.
Zaheer, if you suffocate Tenzin, I am gonna kill a nearby box of crackers. Nope. Off-camera beat him up. Got it. You would be dead. Not quite sure about Sue anymore. After all, even if she started out as part of the Red Lotus, she definitely wouldn't stand for her daughter being threatened. Oh well, it was a fun speculation. Still, something could go down later. I gotta say, my heart was in my throat this whole episode. The build-up to the finale is great so far, but Korra's got a history of underwhelming Deus Ex climaxes. You know, to counteract Avatar's Deus Ex climaxes. Can you follow through? How are the writers possibly gonna top this next season? Subscribe, comment, etc., and you stay shiny, Animaniacs!